The Sandown handicap hurdle is next up, men. This is a 0-90 handicap hurdle, so what a low grade race. This one, 2 miles and 6 furlongs. The trip, and the top one is Glowing Shrew for James Shea, Sponge Bandit for Ryan Costello, Daddy Al McRae for Alex Cherry on a three-timer, and a 0-90 Billy Vodden Tapper for Thomas Rogers, Wind Chime Alex Cherry, Astro Charm Glances Martellin, and Pashu de Polder, Obi-Wan, Ring of Esteem Thomas Rogers, Final Delivery Dan Hughes, Lexington Performer Vinnie Gerard, and Winchester for Daniel French. So that's your field then of 11. This could be interesting, this. And away they go. I've got a feeling quite a few of these might be chasers exploiting a low hurdle mark, but we'll soon see. And Wind Chime is the first one to show. Here's Lexington Performer and Glowing Shrew second and third as they get to the first of the 12. With Winchester just the last one to take it. But Wind Chime is in the lead as they get to the second. And they're all jumping. Okay, so far, with Wind Chime 5 or 6 lengths clear. Oh, Glowing Shrew in second. Just the one grey in this race, that's Astro Charm Glances. So they get to the third. All safely over the third. The order pretty much the same as before. Wind Charm in the lead and the rest of them pretty tightly grouped together. Lexington Performer, the one that's just running a little bit wide on the track. And it's probably the back marker. And all this deceptive as they get to the fourth. And there's no doubt about the leader. Oh, one is a four of their Astro Charm Glances has gone. So there you go. And that's a chaser managing to fall in a hurdle. So Astro Charm Glances has got rid of the jockey and is the first one out of the race. And Wind Chime is 6 or 7 lengths clear. Pashu de Polder in second. And Daddy Al McRae is third. Then Winchester and Billy Vodden Tapper. And then Final Delivery, Glowing Shrew. Sponge Bandit after that, then Ring of Esteem, and finally Lexington Performer. So 2 miles still to go then. Wind Chime is bowling along comfortably in the lead. All safely over flight 5 with Wind Chime clear. Pashu de Polder probably 8 to 10 lengths back in second now. Come up past the stand, take the flight, which will be the last on the next circuit. And they're all safely over that one, although Final Delivery didn't jump it all that well. And it's now dropped to the back of the pack. It's Wind Chimes is going to pass the winning post with a circuit to go with a clear lead of 8 lengths or so to Glowing Shrew in the green jacket second. Winchester has moved up nicely on the inside into third, the yellow jacket of Pashu de Polder behind that one, Ring of Esteem wide on the track in the two shades of green, then the orange sleeves of Daddy Al McRae, and Sponge Bandit and Billy Vodden Tapper. Lexington Performer on the outside, and then the back marker now, the blue jacketed Final Delivery. So they make their way towards the next then, racing through the rain, and Wind Chime is swinging along nicely in front to Glowing Shrew second, Winchester third, Ring of Esteem four. Lexington Performer is moving up nicely around the outside. Pashu de Polder the Wind Chime's lead is now down to a little more than two, and Lexington Performer is the one that's really moving up on the outside as they get over flight number 7. Just all safely over. Wind Chime comes to number 8, still in the lead. From Glowing Shrew and Winchester now back up into third. As Lexington Performer's just been dropped back a little bit there, whether that's tactical or what, we'll wait and see. As they get over the 9th. They're all over the 9th and just 3 more to take, and Wind Chime has now been joined by Glowing Shrew. Lexington Performer, Winchester are next, and then Ring of Esteem and Billy Vodden Tapper running together on the outside. Sponge Bandit being pushed along. Daddy Al McRae totally lost his place. Final Delivery and Pashu de Polder also out the back as they get over the third last. And Wind Chime responding to the jockey's urgings is now back up into a length and a half lead again, pulling away from Glowing Shrew. Ring of Esteem is probably just about third. Winchester, though, has got the inside just about, although glowing shrews in his way a little bit. Sponge Bandit trying to come around the outside of them as well, but Wind Chimes kicked on again and he's five lengths clear again now as they're racing towards the final couple of flights. And Wind Chime has suddenly gone five or six lengths clear of Ring of Steam, Sponge Bandit, then Winchester and Glowing Shrew. We're now towards these final two flights then now, and Wind Chime is five lengths clear again from Ring of Steam in second, over the second last. Wind Chime landed it over it well. Ring of Steam is starting to close in second, so too is Billy Modern Tapper, then Sponge Bandit on the outside. Difficult to see anything else getting into it at all though, apart from this Wind Chime. At the moment, Wind Chime's got one to jump and he's still got a five length lead. It's Wind Chime's round, it's Cherry racing to the final flight, gets over it well, gets away from it well. It's an uphill run to the finish, but Billy Modern Tapper and Ring of Steam are going to have to sprout wings to get anywhere near him. And Wind Chime, he is sailing away to win this one. Really comfortably up towards the line, it's virtually pillar to post for Wind Chime. Wind Chime takes it, Ring of Steam second, Billy Modern Tapper third, Danny Hammer Kramer on well for fourth, and I think Pashuda Pole there might have been the last one to finish. Wind Chime took that race by the scruff of the neck and dictated the pace all the way through the race. Nothing got a blow in at all, really. One of the easiest wins we've seen for a while. As Wind Chime takes it, let's get a full list of the placings and the connections. It's Wind Chime, the winner for Alex Cherry. Ring of Steam was second for Thomas Rogers, who was also third with Billy Vodden Tapper. Daddy Amacray was fourth for the winning trainer, Alex Cherry. And Winchester was fifth for Daniel French.